The starting lineup for the visiting Cleveland Cavaliers. At point guard, Jose Calderon. At the other guard position, George Brown. At power forward, Jeff Green. At center, Kevin Love. At the other forward position, LeBron James. The head coach of the visiting team is Tyrone Stewart.
The 76ers here in Philadelphia as 2K Sports brings you today's action live from the Wells Fargo Center. Thanks for joining us, everyone. It's the NBA on 2K Sports. Kevin Harlan here with Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg, and we'll have David Aldridge filling us in from the sideline. Coming in off the road, the 76ers are back in Philadelphia for this game, and they're battling it out for playoff position, presently 8 games off the lead.
And I think for the 76ers, they must have reached every goal they set for themselves this season. For them to be this high in the standings, this late in the season, what an accomplishment.
And I know it took a long time for people around the league to trust their success, but I don't think there's anybody left out there who doesn't think they're for real at this point.
And a look at the starters for the Cavaliers. They've got LeBron James. Green is out there with Kevin Love. Then there's Hill, and it's Calderon in at the point guard. And good that time.
And a smooth jump shot from the veteran Green there. These are looks he nails consistently.
And it's good, 2 points. Redick's got his first basket.
And can you always depend on him or what to lead you to the right place with that pass? Money.
And Ben Simmons has what I think is elite defensive potential. Quick feet, quick hands, good size, good IQ. And he's a terrific rebounder.
There's a chance he could go for a big game if they don't D him up on the perimeter.
Johnson the screen. Sharich outside. Calderon against Simmons. Again, Philadelphia.
That's a confident play there. Great execution.
Love with the screen for James. Up off the screen. And there's the nice layup by Love.
Boy, Love is really good at getting inside the paint, establishing position, has an excellent feel for how to score around the basket.
Hill with it. Now guarded by Redick. Hill kicks to Calderon. And he could not get that one to go. Out of contact, and he'll go to the line for two.
We're watching a legend. And LeBron James said he's chasing a ghost. He wants to be the greatest player of all time.
This is his first trip to the line tonight. The first free throw is good. Both free throws good for LeBron.
And, you know, the Sixers were heavily criticized for the so-called process, enduring the pain of losing big. People forget the prior decade when the team tried to contend, only won a single playoff series. Gotta like how they've come out here. I mean, connecting on four of their first five shots, yes, that's good.
It's a pick by Love. Outside, Green. Passes it to LeBron. And the layup is good. And Clark, it's true, the Sixers were a team long stuck in the middle. Does that help explain why they employed such drastic measures to rebuild?
I think so, Kevin. Clearly, they tried getting there the usual way when you try to develop players and maybe add a key free agent here or there. And it didn't quite work. And the process was Plan B. And that process has really started to pay some dividends, so I don't blame them for trying.
So, timeout called here, the first for Cleveland. This game coming on the heels of their win against Toronto.
Yeah, and fortunately for them, I thought the opponent's defense just never showed up.
Yeah, you know what? The waters were calm for most of the game. I mean, little resistance, felt like they could get any look they wanted at any time. Pull me back then, but it's getting hard for you to fake it now. Being rich when I'm 40, man, I'm trying to make it now.
And the 76ers with a completely new group now. A post-All-Star break look now at how the breakdown between three-pointers and other shots have been for the 76ers.
And clearly they haven't been shy about launching it from long range. That's the way the league has been going, and they are certainly embracing that trend.
The Cavaliers have gone 4-of-4 to start, so a nice offensive rhythm to start here. Clarkson dishes to Thompson. Outside Hood, and the whistle blows. It's going to be on Marco Bellinelli. That's his first foul. And Clark, when you look around the league today, is there a player that you watched and think, hey, yeah, that reminds me of how I used to play?
There are a number of guys that come to mind a little bit. Tobias Harris is an outstanding player, terrific young player and young man. Has a game similar to mine in that he's really versatile, does a lot of things well, not super flashy, but very productive. He comes to mind right off the top of my head, current.
And good passing, setting up a lot of these buckets right now, Kevin. That's been the key.
Dime dropping delights is what I call it.
Yeah, it's a nice pass. I will give you that.
Yep, he's on the money. That's no doubt. A shot by Clarkson, no good.
And that's the shot you want to create. They just can't get it to fall.
That's what I call an everything but. Good execution, just didn't knock it down. But you're right, they're happy with that shot.
And they've scored several times already here in the first quarter on the inside.
Screen by Smith to end the run, and that's 2 points on the layup. Nance has got his first bucket of the night.
Now how about how he sets his man up there, runs him right into the screen, and then gets the basket.
Holmes, that's a screen. Here's Anderson, and it's blocked. But they get it there. Shot clock at 6. The shot by Bellinelli. No good. And the layup's good off the glass.
And those are the kind of nice inside looks they've gotten here in the first half.
And here's Ilyasova outside. Good. And McConnell gets the assist. A free-flowing first quarter. Great scoring through one. 76ers lead by 4. Live from Philadelphia, you're watching 2K Sports. And J.J. Redick, a focal point in his tenure with the Duke Blue Devils, both offensively and as a lightning rod for fans.
I think I'll forever be associated with Duke and Duke basketball. And obviously that's a polarizing topic for some people. They like me, some people don't like me. But I take a lot of pride in the fact that I went to school there, I got to play there, and I graduated from Duke.
There's no doubt that he is Mr. Duke, J.J. Redick, and it's hard to argue with that school's incredible success, Greg, whether you like him or not. And I know you've had a first-hand view of Duke a couple times.
I have the utmost respect for J.J. and Coach K and what they've done there. And listen, you could be known for a lot worse things in your life and haven't gone to a lot worse places. But I think for him, it's not about where he's been, Kev. I think it's about where he's going, what's going to be the next chapter in his career.
All right, the second quarter beginning in just a moment. Let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for the 76ers.
They've been making some really nice passes out there, excellent passing. That could set the tone for the rest of the game.
And keep an eye on the three-point shooting, because that has been a factor as well. If they can maintain that current form, they can be successful.
And a moment now to reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up for the second quarter of basketball. And so in the game for the Cavaliers,
what's up, gentlemen?
Jordan Clarkson is out there with Rodney Hood. Then there's J.R. Smith. Then there's Tristan Thompson. And it's Nance in at the power forward position. That free throw good from Anderson. And picks taken in the late first round can be a bit of a crapshoot, Clark. But Justin Anderson, taken with the 21st pick back in 2015, he sure seems like a keeper.
Yeah, I concur with everything you said there, Kevin. I mean, seeing him at Virginia, you knew he had the physical tools. It's just a matter of developing his skills and his shooting ability to be able to succeed at this level, and I think he will.
And so here is Philadelphia. After the Cavaliers pick up three, nice work there coming off the screen. Fultz has got the lead up to five now for the 76ers. And the ball goes out of bounds. Nice touch by Hood.
No clue where that pass was going. That is a brutal turnover.
And the 76ers will go for a different look here. Johnson, he's checked in for Rashawn Holmes. Sharch comes in for Ilyasova. Robert Covington's checked in for Justin Anderson. And it's Ben Simmons in for Bellinelli. Now, here's Fultz. 5-point lead, the biggest of the game. And that one, good. Simmons got his second bucket tonight.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball movement.
Really a prime example of the difference in how these teams have operated offensively. Much more individual play at the other end. Boy, you gotta love that assist by LeBron.
Screen by Sharich. Simmons against Hill. And Ben Simmons again. Simmons got 4 points in the quarter. LeBron outside. And LeBron throws it down.
And LeBron is a force rolling to the rim. When he's diving inside, he's looking for the punch.
Philadelphia leading by four to the inside. And that's out of bounds. Philadelphia will retain possession. And a look here at the scoring trend over the last several months for Hood.
It's been surprising to me to see him take a little bit of a tumble lately in terms of what he's doing for them offensively. The points just haven't been there for him like they were a few months back. The defenses he's facing have adjusted to him, and he hasn't been able to make his own adjustments.
On defense, Cleveland. Johnson the screen. Covington passes to Simmons. Over Hill. Lands soft on the front of the rim and drops. Simmons got 8 points. And Brett Brown, such a great fit in Philadelphia. He loves the town, loves the game, loves to coach. he says about the town clerk, it reminds him of his hometown.
Well, that's nice to hear because he does embody a lot of the grit that you come to know and expect from Philadelphians. I mean, it reminds him of where he's from. He's faced the media through tough times. He's always candid and forthright. And he's coaching with a long lens, as he put it, building towards something great. And, man, I tell you, that passion and enthusiasm just oozes out of him, which is pretty cool to see.
Five on the clock. The Cavaliers pull it in. Last time they met in Cleveland.
And their last time playing this club, foul trouble became a big problem for them. Their starters had to take an early stint on the bench.
They've just got to be more careful tonight. It's that simple. I mean, those guys are too valuable. They need them on the floor.
Here's Covington. After the Cavaliers pick up three, Sharge with the screen for Covington. It's stolen by Hill, and the Cavaliers pushing it up now. And the shot no good, a bit short for Philadelphia. They've gone 5 of 6 so far from the field in the second quarter. And Sharge kicks to Simmons. Covington, a screen on Hill. Green by Sharich. Here's Johnson. Another miss by Philadelphia.
Well executed. Great rhythm. You've got to finish that one.
Agree with you there, partner, because that screen really freed him up nicely, and that's a shot. But if you're a pro, you need to make that one.
I tell you what, it's almost like stealing to watch how he plays the game from this seat.
And the first half comes to a close. We've got a close game going on here. Cavaliers ahead as they wrap up the second quarter on a 12-4 run. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Kevin, thanks. Here with Jose Calderon. Jose, what is working so far, and what has to happen in the second half?
I think we're just helping each other. You know, it's not about one guy. It's everybody. They got really good players out there, so we're just trying to help each other and keep the turnovers down and just don't let them run to their place comfortable. So I think that's the key.
We'll see if you can keep making it hard for him in the second half. Thanks for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. And we'll be back after halftime as the third quarter gets underway.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
And we hope you enjoyed the competitive first half of action. Ernie Johnson here welcoming you back to the 2K Sports Halftime Show. That guy right there is Shaquille O'Neal. And that guy right there is Kenny the Jet Smith. The first quarter for the Cavaliers was fairly even. They only had a couple rough stretches, and as the first period came to a close, they had a 4-point deficit. In the second quarter, they erased what had been a fairly big deficit at one point, and now here they are sitting on a 1-point halftime lead. Kenny, your thoughts. How are the Cavaliers playing?
Well, their shooting accuracy was on point. It was good play calling, of course, by the coaching staff, but it was great execution by the team.
And over to Shaq. What did you think about Philadelphia?
I think it was their passing that's kept them in the game. You can see it in their assist numbers. They were very, very unselfish. The ball moving from side to side, guys making good cuts. It's enabled them to create a lot of chances. As long as they stay on the same page and keep working together, they got a great chance to take control of this game.
And now, folks, just moments away from the start of the third quarter.
We have a close ball game on our hands as we get set for the second half of basketball. What can you say, LeBron James? What an impressive effort today.
His points production thus far, off the charts. It's only been two quarters, just a great effort for him for the entire half.
Yeah, and it doesn't matter where he is on the floor either, Greg. He's making it look very easy. He's looking to score the ball.
Welcome back, everybody. The start of the second half getting underway. Both teams battling hard through the first half. Redick and Covington make up the perimeter. Johnson is out there with Dario Saric, and it's Simmons in at the point.
And there's no question that James is one of the best dunkers ever. A forceful finisher who loves showing off his athleticism.
And the replay presented, of course, by Under Armour. Unleash chaos. Great stuff and some great basketball going on. Back to Simmons. And Simmons slams it in.
And he's an auto automatic finisher when he gets into that area.
He is, and he picks the simple one-hand stuff to get the 2 points.
Hey, guys, I know I'm stating the obvious here, but those could be an important 2 points considering how close this game is.
Back to Redick. And if you're just joining us, we play it over a minute here in the third. Charge outside. Pass to Simmons. Over Calderon, and it's Simmons. That time on the assist by Sharks. Clark, most great defenders are at the forward positions in the league right now.
Yeah, they are, and I tell you what, boy, you talk about Klay Thompson shooting, but defensively, he is actually, he's an instructional video, what he does defensively. He's strong, he's smart, he's disciplined, and he has tremendous lateral quickness. If there's a better defender at the wing position than Klay Thompson. I know Kentavious Caldwell-Pope is in the conversation, Tony Allen, but Klay Thompson gets my number one vote.
Timeout called, Cleveland. Well, J.J. Redick had quite the interesting free agency period. Greg, ultimately he signs with the 76ers on a huge one-year, $23 million deal.
Yeah, and this is the team that wanted him. Great fit with his shooting, something that they obviously needed. And Redick had a lot of suitors, but he saw something developing with this young Philly core.
Platoon swap here for Cleveland. Now that we have a second, take a look at the teams that have scored the most points off turnovers over the last 10 games. Fourth, the 76ers.
Just a terrific job over this stretch of forcing turnovers and capitalizing. They'd love to continue that trend.
Hood dishes to Thompson. Some nice passing by Cleveland here. Nance sets a screen for Smith. Pulls from the top of the key. And a big bounce off the rim, but it sinks right in. Philadelphia has gone a very strong 4-for-5 from three-point land in the ballgame. Holmes sets a screen. And Bellinelli kicks to Anderson. He dishes it to Fultz. The rebound by Nance.
Even with that miss, they're shooting 75% coming out of the break. That's a strong start to the half.
Guys, what a back and forth game this has been.
And that's already resulted in 7 lead changes.
Here's Fultz. Softly drops in the floater. Fultz has got the game tied up here for Philadelphia.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Yeah, and that's 4 straight field goals now, Greg, they've allowed from point blank range. Can't happen.
Nance a screen. Here's Hood. A second chance effort. It's blocked.
Boy, the defensive chops of Ilyasova really coming into play here. I mean, quite surprising, actually impressive at how good he is at timing those shot blocks.
Moving it around, 8 of their last 10 coming off assists.
And Greg, you know nothing makes a coach happier than selflessness on the basketball court.
Now, here's Clarkson. Tight defense on him. The shot's good. Clarkson's got 7.
Boy, so much confidence in himself, especially for a young guy. I mean, Clarkson drains it with a hand in his face.
And the 76ers decide to take their first timeout here. They put up a nice win against Detroit the last time out.
Just a terrific effort off the bench. Guys came in, they seemed fresh, and they all contributed.
Yeah, you need that juice, that gas coming off the pine. Always a luxury to have a deep bench. And when they can step in and play well, you're in good shape.
And the 76ers making a change here. McConnell's checked in. James checked in for the Cavaliers. Holmes, that's a screen. Here's Bellinelli over Nance. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. The 76ers shooting their second and third free throws tonight.
And 75% on the season as a unit from the free throw line.
You know, their percentage has dropped off just a little bit compared to last year, guys, but it's not a huge drop off, so no major concern.
And he knocks down the first one. Robert Covington's checked in for Fultz. Both free throws good from Bellinelli.
And that's the norm for him. He's pretty much automatic when he's at the line.
Clarkson kicks to Nance. Nance a screen. 34 seconds left here in the third quarter.
Oh, a nice tip in to salvage the points from that missed shot.
Yeah, and those second chance points can add up.
And if you're the defensive team, it just kills you to give up baskets like that.
McConnell passes to Ilyasova. The 76ers need to get off a shot, but they recover it. A shot by McConnell, no good. Tipped away. Holmes with the steal. It's all tied in Philadelphia. And we're coming right back after this break to get the fourth quarter underway. The fourth quarter of action getting underway. We've had a great one so far with both sides coming to play. So on the floor for Cleveland, we've got Kevin Love. Hands out there with LeBron James. Then there's Calderon, and it's Hill in at the two guard. Johnson can't hit. Cleveland's gone a terrific 5 of 6 from beyond the arc in this game. And it's Hill. That time the assist by Calderon. Hill's got the fourth quarter started here with a bucket for the Cavs. Johnson in the corner. Banked in off the glass. Johnson's got it all tied up now for the 76ers.
And so far, this has got that feel of a game that could be back and forth all the way.
Yeah, not a lot of separation in this one, Greg. Both teams looking for that one big run to grab momentum.
And it's LeBron missing.
And you can see the defenders afraid to kind of get in his way a lot of times when he's on his way to the basket. But on that one, they were there.
Simmons dishes to Johnson. The basket good off the assist from Simmons. And the 76ers lead by 2. And guys, what do you think about the hustle stats here for the 76ers?
Contested shots and block shots. They're bread and butter defensively. They're giving up no easy looks.
But also, they put the offense on its heel. Look at the number of steals they've been able to get. And that's something they also can take great pride in. And the fact that James is so aggressive here, constantly looking to score when he's in rhythm.
Oh, the lob for Simmons. Out of bounds. Cleveland will take possession.
And that's just carelessness there. I mean, you have got to have your head in the game.
J.J. Redick's checked in for Philadelphia. The Cavaliers have gone 2 of 4 from the field since we started the final quarter of play. Out of bounds, it'll be 76ers ball.
Bad turnover, plain and simple. No other way to describe it. I mean, he just threw it out of bounds.
Last quarter of play, about 2 minutes in now. And Simmons kicks to Covington. Count that one.
Oh, Covington really is fantastic at getting his arms high in the air when he's attempting a shot inside. Really gives the defense no chance to catch up to it or get to it.
LeBron kicks to Hill. 6 on the shot clock. Shoots over Covington. A shot by LeBron. No good. 76ers have gone 3 of 4 in field goal attempts since getting things started here in the fourth. Charge outside. The basket good off the assist from Simmons. Simmons got his seventh assist of the game with that last one. James against Covington. James in the post. Shoots over Covington. Tried to bank it in, but he misses.
Has to be disappointing seeing him miss that one, Kevin. I mean, the defense wasn't bad, but still, I think he needs to convert from there.
Here's Redick. Charge passes to Simmons. Calderon pulls it in. The Cavaliers trail by five. James left side. And he banks in the layup.
Man, you got to respect and appreciate how polished LeBron is inside. I mean, he really excels at creating opportunities for himself close to the rim.
Simmons left side. That's rebounded by Cleveland. Calderon a screen on Redick. Johnson against James. And he hammers that one down right in the face of Dario Saric.
Boy, is it tough to stop LeBron right now.
Covington setting the pick for Redick. Johnson the screen. Here's Simmons. Connects.
Timeout.
That is cold-blooded. Indeed it is. Love seeing him deliver when they need him most. No fear taking these shots. I love it.
Timeout called. Cleveland. They're trailing by three. 41 seconds left in the game. For our Jordan player of the game, Ben Simmons.
And his focus, guys, has been laser sharp, and his touch from the field, flawless. The teammates have worked hard to get him the ball in some good positions, and boy, has he rewarded them with a spectacular shooting performance. Great call to keep running all those sets for him.
Checked in for Larry Nance. He gets a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, guys, over the break, I was able to listen to Tyronn Lue's huddle. This game is close, and he told his players, hey, guys, this is when it's fun, right? This is a close game, and this is when you get to show what you're made of. Right here, right now. Kevin, we'll see how they respond.
Thank you, David. About 3 seconds between shot and game clock. Redick against Hill. Redick dishes to Covington. Johnson with a screen on Love. Here's Simmons. It falls!
Hey, when the game is tight and snug, Simmons rises to the occasion, effortlessly capitalizing when his team desperately needs him to do so.
Timeout called the Cavaliers. They're trailing by five. Just 4 seconds left in the fourth quarter. What's your take, guys?
Yeah, this has been rough all the way around. I mean, coming in with high hopes and then just now trying to finish the best they can.
Well, Greg, this one's clearly over. This is done. But hopefully they can find some momentum to carry into the next game.
There's Green with the three. Love. No good.
Boy, I tell you, the long reach of Covington really bothering Shooter. I mean, he enjoys making life difficult for whoever he's assigned to.
So the 76ers win it. It was up for grabs right until the final seconds.
Yeah, and for me, Kevin, what stood out is just the overall trust this group has in one another when it matters most. Doing what had to be done and to send these fans home happy.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Greg Anthony, Clark Kellogg, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.